अस्सलाम वालेकुम ऑल. सो वेलकम बैक टू पॉजिटिव साइकोलॉजी. द टॉपिक दैट नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज ऑल अबाउट द पेशेंस, सब्र. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द रिलीजन पर्सपेक्टिव, सो इन रिलीजन पर्सपेक्टिव सब्र हैज अ लॉट ऑफ इम्पोर्टेंस. It is said whenever the word sabr comes, so it always comes with the sabran jamilun. That means having the patience is the highest virtue. It has the highest reward. When we talk about the other religion, a lot of bigger scholars used to have the patience because they wanted to have the highest and very fruitful reward. Even it is said that sabr ka phal meeta hota hai, and you have other concept even that if you are patiently waiting for something, so you are going to wait for the greatest reward ever. If we talk about in the religion perspective, in Islamic perspective, that we have a lot of prophets who had a greatest patience. If you talk about Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, he has waited, he has no any, you know, kids. So he prayed to Allah for 80 years that, "Ey Allah, O Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, give me the children. Even if we talk about Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam, how he had patience with his brothers, how he survived his life. If we talk about Hazrat Moses alayhi salam, Hazrat Musa alayhi salam, how he went through with his the era of the throne. If you listen to the story of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, how he had passion that even his own son didn't listen to him whenever it was coming the storm. Even if you think the normal people who are the good scholar, who are the greatest people in our religion in Islam, even if you talk about the other religion scholar, They always talk greatest importance to the patience. Why I have selected this topic, even especially in this context? Patience. Today's youth has become so impatient. Even they get a degree, they wanted a job of 1 lakh rupees on the very first day. They wanted a house within a year. They wanted a car within 1 month. They wanted to have everything within a few years because they want everything so quick. If they are not going to get that thing so quick, so they go with the depression, stress. They started to think a lot of negative. So that's why I have selected this topic to have the powder upon this, that how patience is important. If you say, what is patience? Patience is not the ability to wait, but the ability to keep a good attitude while waiting. It's not that you are waiting and you are crying, "Oh God, what has happened to me? I'm not getting this. So keeping a good attitude while waiting is a patience. Now, even whenever we are going to get any good job, even you are going to get any good salary package, we are talking about the worldly things now. Even you are going to get a very good successful life, so it's the journey. It is the complete process. A lot of people, if we talk about the Vice Chancellor of Sikhar IBA, who get that much respect, honor, gratitude, dignity, so he had the whole journey. How he has gone through that journey. If we see successful people, they are not successful within the blink of eye. They have went through sacrifices, a lot of things in their life. If you see your own teachers who have got this position, that's a status, even they have their own journey. Even if you see yourself, the people who are surrounding by you with the same class, you would be having your old class fellows who are not know who are seeing you as a good university, good institute. Even reaching to that institute, it was not easy for you. It has the journey. So having patience is very much important. So like I have quoted few examples. So there is one of the famous book author, he's the writer, Stephen King. He has sold his novel almost 350 million copy of the novel. So King's first novels were rejected a total 30 times before publish. So it has the huge patience journey. Even you discuss, we talk more about the Disney world, Disney cartoons, Disney movies, Disney parks, Disney characters. So Disney is the biggest creative company of the world. Walt Disney actually was a person who was fired from the newspaper job because of he was not having a good imagination. Now you see the most imaginative cartoons, the industry, movies are being created in Disney. So he was being fired because having a no imagination. So it was a patient. After a few failed business, Disney upbeat attitude was clearly that kept him going on. So this is how we have to think that having a patience is very much important. Once you wait for something, having a good attitude, so you are going to wait for the miracles to happen. So every successful person have a journey. You are also going to pass a journey. So don't be impatient for anything. If you are not getting job for 1 year, so it's okay. Keep trying. Having a good attitude. Invest your time with the good things. Keep moving. Keep trying. If you're not going to buy a home within 2 years, so don't be impatient. Okay? Have a patience. Everything has a journey. Everything has a time. Everyone has their own story of reaching the success. So we must not lose the patience. So we need to have that patience all the time. The other topic that we are going to discuss now is the inner peace. Now, it is very important that we should have that spiritual calmness in our body and heart. Inner peace refers to the deliberate state of psychological or spiritual calm despite the potential presence of stressor. We know that if you are a kid or a parent or a teacher or even an old man, so there are a lot of stressors available. For a kid, he has to go to work. He has to go to the tuition, the school, madrasa. They are the stressors. Even your parents, you have a lot of work, so you have a lot of stressor outside. Even if you are old, so you have a lot of stressors outside. You have to take medicine, you have to think about your diseases and a lot of things. So, inner peace, deliberately you need to keep yourself in the spiritual calmness. How you can get this? This is very much important and we need to learn. We can never obtain peace in the outer world until we make peace within ourselves. It's the Buddha. Buddha used to have a lot of spiritual, prayers, a lot of spiritual prayers, a lot of meditation in order just to connect to the universal attraction and the greatest power of the world. So if you want to be peaceful, you cannot get peace with the outer world. It's always inside you. You need to search that peace available within yourself. You need to explore it. So I have mentioned few of the techniques through which you can enhance your inner peace. One of the technique is the breathing technique. Try this power of the breath. Inhale for 4 seconds and then imagine releasing your stressful feelings. When you exhale for following 6 seconds, repeat 10 times. This is one of the best test practice available that makes you peaceful. Whenever we have inhale and exhale breathing, we pump our heart. Once we pump our heart, it gives signals to our brain that everything is working very normal, everything is coming very right. So once we give a lot of signals to our brain, so we are going to ultimately give the very positive feelings, and we get a peace in our mind and our soul. So this is very good practice that you can do. The other is walk away. You know your triggers. If a conversation turns unpleasant or situation is over, simple excuse. Go walk away. Do not be with the negative people. Do not think more negative. Stop being hurting yourself with negativity. The other is write in a journal. This is one of the very good practice. To reap the full benefits of journaling, go beyond the superficial by learning to use your journal for your personal growth. Whenever we start writing for the few days, we used to discuss and talk about the superficial things about our life. Once we think about more, or kya likhu, once we started to dig out ourselves, we go into detail of our deep thinking. What we are in real sense, what we have, because we are giving time to ourselves. So journaling is very good practicing in order to get you at peace, because once you know yourself more, so you are going to control yourself more and you are going to have more inner peace. Get moving. It really does not matter what you do here. Just move out of your head into your body for at least 5 minutes. Again, the meditation concept. Sit for 5 minutes on the very clean floor. Inhale, exhale your breath. Whenever you are going to exhale your breath, think that you are leaving all the stress out. So you generate a lot of positive vibes. Even you can dance to your favorite song, jump up and down. Because once you do this practice, ultimately you are going to have the pumping of your heart that is going to give the positive signals to your brain. Then reread a good books. This is a good practice. Yahan pe to bache jo hai na apni course ka book bhi nahi padte. But again, if you are interested in any of the things, which is very good, so you can go and reread the book again, which is good, which is also releases. Express your gratitude. One of the bestest practice to get the peace, inner peace, is paying your gratitude. All the things, all the time. Even once you are buying clothes from the shop, same thank you. Even if you are taking food from your mummy or your sisters, same thing. Say her thank you. Even you are receiving money from your father, say him thank you. Because they are putting efforts for you. Even say thanks, a lot of gratitude to Allah. Allah ko jo sabse cheez pasand hai, wo kya hai? Shukr. Allah ko sabse jo cheez pasand hai, wo shukr pasand hai. So we need to be very grateful for all the things. Then we need to meditate. So I have also given the link. You can do practice of meditation. So this is how you can get the inner peace. Then pray, spend time with and discuss with Allah, who is the superpower. This is the one of the very good practice. Once we discuss ourselves in front of Allah, because it is said that your superpower, there is no gap and no any curtain between you, yourself and your superpower. So whenever you are in pray, whenever you stand your hand for dua, discuss your issues, seek for help. Pay him gratitude. This is how you can get a very good inner peace. The other topic that we are going to discuss now is the spirituality and religion is means of achieving the happiness. I'm not going into deep to discuss about the spirituality and religion. Spirituality and religion, what the both things are. So religion is actually more all about, you are doing the practices, rites, you know what is wrong and right, keeping you the religion, what is true and false. spirituality, where do I feel find meaning to the life, how do I feel connected, what should I live. So this is all about searching yourself bigger than you, and this is all about practicing the things which is guided by your religion. Both the things are overlapping, more core things, which is your belief, which is your comfort, which is your reflection, your ethics, your all. So this is how the core thing is we wanted to achieve, the belief and comfort. So how materialism and spiritualism is different. Most of the people nowadays thinking and going more towards the spirituality. Materialism, you are getting happy and you are more towards the money and the things available to you. Spiritualism, you more believe on the things which are abstract. You believe in giving to others. You believe in, you know, searching the meaning of life. You believe giving the supernature. Right? So, which one is the most stronger? Spiritualism. Because it is guiding you the way you wanted to live your life. Now question arises, why? Why spirituality and religion is a means of achieving the happiness? This is important to you. Spirituality is about seeking the meaningful connection with something bigger than yourself, which can result in the positive emotions such as peace, awe, contentment, gratitude and acceptance. This is very much important to understand. Once we are going to think that we are not that much bigger, we are nothing. If we started to think that we are nothing, so we say there is something which is bigger to us. We are nothing, so our ego is very less. We started to give more. We started to be relaxed more. We started to pay more gratitude to the things. We started to accept more things. And once we are having these all things, so obviously, once we are following our religion in a more peacefully, so we are going to get support from Allah. We believe. I am, you know, praying my Allah, I am following my religion, so something good would happen. This is our belief. Allah would never do something wrong to me. It is my belief. So I am going to have more high self-esteem. My sense of security would be very high, and I am going to have the positive life. Because I know God is with me. I feel sense of security. Security in sense of I am doing good things. I am following my religion properly. So, I am going to have Jannat. I'm going to have paradise because I'm following my religion properly. So, you become more peaceful and contented with regards to this world and hereafter. Even it is being worldly, the research has been conducted and it is said that the spiritual and religion people live the longer life. They stay more happy and peaceful because they know the meaning of their life, why they are here. They have the sense of security, self-esteem, contentment, gratitude, acceptance, passions, very high. So they remain more happy. Then the other topic that we are going to discuss is why traveling and meeting different people makes us happier. Why it is so? Okay, one of the research was conducted in 2016. The Happiness 360 Conference with the partnership of the UN's World Tourism Organization established that happiest people on the earth travel more. According to the neuroscientist, when we travel, we rewire our brains. You know the rewire? We create some new wires in our brain, the new waves in our brain. This is because new experiences are the key to build new neural pathways in the brain. Once you are going to have new pathway in the brain, by rewiring your brain, you become more creative and accepting of the new idea. This is why travel makes you happy. once we are traveling more, we are going to create more new wires, new paths in our brain. Once we are going to create new wires and new paths in our brain, so we are going to accept more new ideas. We are going to be more open-minded. A lot of people who are very aggressive and very rigid and very negative attitude, once they live only 4 years in the Western world, they are completely changed. Why? Because they travel, they meet new people, they see how things are happening, and they started to realize how much we were wrong. Even I had one of my teacher, he used to be very aggressive, very much aggressive, and he went to, you know, Australia. He spent 2 years there. Now, whenever he has back, he used to say, care, compassion, listening to people, empathy is everything. We need to understand people. We need to share love to the people. So he became so polite. He has left his all the anger. Because he started to accept the new ideas because of meeting with the different people. Right? So that's why traveling makes you more happier. That builds more relationship. Even travels build a lot of new relationship. It strengthens the connection with the existing relationships. Even if you are going with your family for the trip, so you are going to build more strength and connection. If you are going for travel to your spouse, so you are going to strengthen your connection. So it is very good. So we should go with our family, our siblings, our, you know, kids, our spouse, in order to spend a good time in travel, so we strengthen our connection. It grow yourself. You receive more knowledge from the different people, different ideas, different religion, their own belief, and you started to learn more of yourself. So this is how travel makes you more happier than the money, than the things that you have, right? So this is the research. The other topic that we are going to discuss is the search for meaning and the purpose in the life. As I also discussed this topic a bit in the religion and spirituality, once we have meaning in our life and purpose in life, we are more contented, we are more peaceful, we are more satisfied. Because let's suppose your purpose of life is to serve the humanity, like Edie Saab had his meaning and purpose in life. He remained more satisfied. He remained, you know, more contented, more peaceful. He's always stick to his purpose. So always search the purpose of your life, why you are living, why you live here, what is your ultimate goal, what you want to contribute to the society. So search for meaning or purpose is very important. Life feels meaningful for the people when they can satisfactorily answer the big question about their lives, such as who am I, why I am here, what is truly important to me, what I am supposed to do with my life, what is my ultimate purpose. So you need to identify your purpose of life. That gives you the contentment and satisfaction. A lot of people suicide because they used to think that there is no meaning in the life. If someone has left you, if your beloved one has left you, if your so-called the concepts of the youngsters nowadays, girlfriend and boyfriend, if they leave you, so you are not going to live without you. So there's no meaning in the life. So it's not like this. Life is the gift of Allah. It has nothing to do with the people, right? So we need to be very grateful with the life. It has the beauty. It has the peace. So identify the meaning of the life. In other words, feelings that one's life is significant, comprehensible, purposeful, and maybe necessary for the human psychological functioning. It is the psychological functioning that if you started to believe that I am contributing my services for the better cause, so I feel more contented and satisfied. I feel that I am important, I am significant, I have purpose. Then we talk about the passion. This is not patience, this is passion. What is passion? Dr. Valerian defined the strong inclination towards a self-defining activity that people love, that they consider important, and in which they devote significant amount of time and energy. Passion is everything. Some people have passion with the music, some people have patience with the colors, some people have passion in number, some people have patience in talking, some people have patience in different sort of things. So once you have a good passion, you need to choose your passion for your work, then you are going to enjoy your life. So make passion is a work in your life, then that you would enjoy your life. Once you have passion and the passion is your goal, then your performance would be very high. Even you know, in the Three Idiot movie, the concept of photography was the patience. So once he said that even I can earn more money, but I won't be satisfied because I'm not going through with my passion. So living your passions is the core thing that make your life enjoying and happy. Whatever makes you happy, do that. If photography makes you happy, do that. Make your time involved in your passion. That keeps you revived. Alright? And then, the important thing, does unfortunate event, loses and trauma makes us the stronger person? What is the trauma? Emotional trauma is one of the most unrecognized, undiagnosed and unreported form of trauma. Emotional trauma. Losing job or a house, death of the loved ones, car accident, unexpected breakups and divorce. This is the biggest form of trauma. Even we can go through this. What do you think? Will that make you a stronger person? Okay, just let me give example of one of the. Suddenly, let's suppose, God forbids, your father has died. It is the will of Allah, everyone has to go. So we need to accept the reality, that is the reality, that whatever is it happened. I mean, losing that person, will that make you stronger? You may take some time to accept the reality. Maybe some people who are more stronger, they take 2 days, 3 days to accept the reality. Even they take 10 days, 1 month to accept the reality. But once you go through this all traumas, research says that makes you more stronger person than ever. Now, your father has left you. Now, you will take the responsibility of doing all the work by yourself. You look after everything, whatever your father was doing before. You create a more sense of responsibility. You started to be behaving like your father with your own family and friends. So this is how you are going to be a more stronger and better person. So these all unfortunate events coming from Allah to make you more stronger. So trust on the superpower God. Even losing your job, if you lose your job, you learn the pain, you went through the pain. Now you are strong enough to go through the pain, and the next time, if something happened the like, so you are able to deal with that. Right? Even once you are going to experience the unexpected breakups, the divorce, you become more stronger person. That is the reality which has happened. It is written in your fate. We cannot deny this. So even those events make you a stronger person. So if something happened that lie, it is not very easy to accept. These are unfilled gaps. I know. I understand. But again, dealing with the grief with acceptance is the best way that we can do. Dealing with the grief is the best way that we can do, and this is how that makes us the stronger person. And this is the new research that we need to accept it. The beautiful concept of generosity. What is generosity? Giving without accepting in return something. Can we give only money? Can we give only, you know, food? No. In generosity, we can give everything. We can give love, we can give passion, compassion, we can show empathy, we can listen to the people, we can give them education, we can support them emotionally, if needed, physically, we can share our food. And a lot of things are coming into generosity. It is the psychological state, whenever we start giving, and giving is not something, it's not something that is our own, habit. It's like our own virtue. Giving is the virtue of Allah. It's the sifat of Allah that He gives. So giving makes you more happier, makes you more contented. If you wear clothes on your own body, you feel happy. If you, you know, make your kids and your sibling wear the same clothes, you become more happier. Is it? If you eat food, if you eat biryani, you become happy. If you buy biryani for others, especially the hungry one, you give them your plate and you saw them eating that biryani, you feel more happy. Generosity, it's so attractive. Generosity, it's so beautiful. If you start giving, Allah gives you more. It is in the Islam and it is in a lot of religion. If you start giving, Allah starts increasing. If you give 1 rupees, Allah increase your 3 rupees. If you spend your time, money, energy in good things, Allah increases strength in this. So generosity is the best virtue that one should have. Not only in form of money, but in form of giving love, smiling, caring. A lot of people are so irritated, they do not even smile at you, they do not even listen to you. Listening to them, showing them compassion, showing them mercy, showing them kindness is the generosity, right? Do all the good you can, by all the means you can, in all the ways you can, in all the places you can, at all the times you can, to all the people you can, as long as ever you can. So this is the generosity, and it's the most beautiful defined in this little poem by John Wellesley. Then we talk about the faith. What is faith? When you want something, the whole universe conspires to help you. It's the Paulo Coelho. Faith is the belief. Faith is the strongest belief, hope that this thing happened. If you have faith in something, you would achieve that thing. Even it is said in Islam and different religion that whatever you think in your mind, you will get that. If you are thinking I will get Jannat, definitely you will get Jannat because it's your faith. If your faith is that you will become one day successful, you would be successful because it's your faith. It has become the belief that you are following it. Faith is your miracle working power. This is the miracle working power. If you are faith, you are ultimately going to work for that because that has become your faith. So always have faith on your dreams. Always have faith on Allah. Always have faith. Do not lose your faith. Hold your faith. It's your own property. The other topic that we are going to discuss now is the concept of healing. Self-healing. If you intuitively feel that you are a healer, or if someone has told you that it's important to trust your ability and use them wisely. This means accepting who you are from a physical, psychological and spiritual perspective. It is also means treating yourself in kind, gentle, supportive way, just as you would support and loved ones in need, one in need. So healing, very important concept that one person do, as I talk about the self-forgivingness. We should heal ourselves. We should be gentle, kind, and treat ourselves in the positive and good way. We should think positive because we are the healer. We should start accepting the way we are. It is also the concept of accepting yourself. A lot of people having this some complex in their mind that I'm not so beautiful, my color is dim and dark. No, start accepting yourself physically, psychologically, and spiritually. This is how you are. So you need to be very kind and gentle to yourself. It's also the blessing from Allah. When you are willing to feel it, so you can heal it. Start feeling is okay, and start healing is zabardast and wonderful. So I have given few examples here that how you can start doing this. Grounding meditation, practice that. The other that I have done is the resonance breathing. The technique is defined in the other that I explained, that first you need to inhale the breath for 4 seconds, then hold, then again exhale 6 seconds, then hold. So this is how you can do the breathing. Then again the journaling, then practice the inner visualization. This is how you can heal yourself, start accepting yourself the way you are. So I would here talk more about the breathing. So this is the inhale, hold, exhale, and hold. Almost the values of the 10%. So resonant breathing can calm you down in a matter of a minute. So it is very good practice. Scientifically proven habits. This is one of the very good application of the breathing, that is called the breathing application. There is a bubble that guide you once it's started to bloom. So you need to breathe and hold, then exhale. So you can download this breathing application in order to practice it. So I recommend you to do this. The last topic that we are going to discuss is the social support. Social support is, I discussed the last topic, social health. Social support in today's era is very much important, because social support make us content and satisfied, help, feel us loved one, feel us cared one. Social support is needed in everyday life. We want it to be loved, cared, respected. So social support is very much important, and we need to get that social support by giving into relationships, by forgiving them a lot, by practicing the gratitude. Try to have 3 things in your relationships. Number one, accept the way they are. They are different. You are different. Neither you are wrong, neither they are wrong. Both are right. Talk to the problems. Second thing, forgive issues. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Forgive. If you forgive them, you are ultimately forgiving yourself, because you are going to remove that hurt and pain from your heart. Right? The third thing, start saying thank you to your relations. Being so grateful for them. Start paying gratitude to them. That's why you can enhance your relationship. And social support is very much important nowadays. Research has signifies after the cancer patient, that if you are a patient and you are getting a lot of social support, so your recovery chances increases. You are going to recover quickly. There was one of the experiment that was conducted with the 2 cancer patients. One was having a very good support from the mother, siblings, and the other patient was not having a good support from their spouse. The both patients start taking the treatment at the same time. The person who get more social support, went through the process of healing more quickly, within the 2.5 years. And the person who was having a, you know, no social support, it took 5 years to heal, but yet it was not almost okay. So social support is very much important in times of bedtime, in the time of needed ones. Even once you are not emotionally good, you need a social support. You feel happy when your mother smiles at you, right? So they would also happy once you smile at them. So be happy with your family, share love, share care, share respect, accept them, and always pay your gratitude to everyone who is surrounding by you. Alright? So that's all about the positive psychology. I hope that lesson would be very much beneficial for you. This is how we can learn from each other. Thank you so much, and Allah Hafiz.